left you last video to work out what would happen if I pressed X instead of R or E at this situation. And hopefully you've had a go and that you know it's going to say you cast a spell on her and she explodes. The reason it does this is because the if statement here is only checking if they have typed the letter R. If they type anything else, it comes down here and it will brew this solution here. This makes sure that our code doesn't error by including an else and capturing all the other things that the user might type in. Okay, so now we have our two outcomes. We need to think about changing the score and changing the number of lives. So to change the number of lives, to begin with, we need to manipulate what is in this variable here. So we begin with three lives and we need to take away a life down here when the occurring catches us. So in the line below it, still indented, we're going to say lives equals lives minus one. This means the new number of lives is the old number of lives minus one. So I'm going to leave a comment there saying lose a life. Now this won't have to do anything to the user on the outside at the moment. This has just happened under the bonnet. Okay, but let's proceed and just change the score here as well. Let's give ourselves 5 points for blowing up the old crane. So we've used score equals score plus 5, and I'm going to leave myself a little reminder to say add 5 to score. This is the new score, is the old score, plus 5. We're not saying score equals 5, we're adding 5 to the score throughout the game. Now, we've changed our score and our lives, but we need to tell the user how to do it, or how many lives and points that they've got. Now, we're going to need to do this quite a few times during the game, so the easiest way to do it now is to set up a function at the top. So if we return up to the top here, and under our rucksack, enter the following code. DEF lives score. Now I've used camel case there with a capital S. You could use snake case like that, or you could call it something entirely different, just something logical rather than bananas or something like that. Then we're going to do two round brackets and a colon and press enter. This should automatically indent underneath, and then we're going to say how many lives and how many points, what our score is, how many points are. So we're going to start with lives. So we're going to say print, you have, comma, lives, comma, lives left. So we have three lives up here. So this will say, you have 3 lives left. Okay, don't get confused by the fact it says lives twice. Print, for the score, your score is colon, comma, score. This will print out the number of lives and this will print out the score that they have. Now, we have put this in a function here because we're going to use that bit of code over and over again. So all we need to do is to enter a tiny bit of code each time we want to list out the score. Now, we should probably tell them what the score and their lives are towards the start of the game. So after we've welcomed them to the adventure, let's tell them what their lives and score is. So we're just going to type lives score, the name of our function. From here, we're just going to use that tiny bit of code to call it. I'll tell you what, let's leave ourselves a blank line underneath before we test it. So here we go, let's test the code. And here we go, it's telling us how many lives we've got left and what our score is to begin with. Okay, super. Now we need to do the same further down the code. So let's take our live score again and let's put it right at the bottom of our code up against the edge of the screen. Okay, so it's not indented inside of our if and it's not indented inside of our else. Make sure it's right up at the edge. That means that it will run whichever option that we have picked here. So let's just test that. Here we go, we've got 2 lives left and our score is 0. Let's run again. We've still got 3 lives left, but this time our score is 5. So we have increased our score here on this occasion and printed out our lives and score. Now we can edit this a little bit. We can make it a bit more fancy by doing things like this, adding a load of asterisks in before and after we list the score and the number of lives to make it really stand out. We could also leave a blank line above and below to space it out a bit more as well. So if you see how it's laid out here at the moment, watch how it's laid out the next time. See, a nice big gap, and the asterisk, it really stands out. So easy to use magic, there we go. So it really stands out and it looks a bit more consistent and professional now. So play around with yours. Make sure you've created a function. Make sure that you have got the number of lives and the score printed out. And make sure that you have used lives and the score in your first scenario using the same way of adding and removing lives and adding and removing the score as I have here. All right, see you next video.